Technology is rapidly evolving in every field, especially in the field of robotics. Robots have been part of our culture for decades, from the kind-hearted R2-D2 in Star Wars to the T-1000 Terminator in the Terminator movies. But today, we are seeing robotics rapidly evolve, particularly based on the emergence of artificial intelligence and machine learning. Here at Duke University, we have Duke Robotics, which is looking at the frontier spaces of robotics, both advancing the capabilities of robots and also how they're deployed in pioneering applications, such as in medicine or in monitoring our environment. I'm Jerry Lynch, Vinnick Dean of Engineering here at Duke University, and it is my pleasure to share with you today the amazing work being done by Professor Boyuan Chen at Duke Robotics.
Boyuan, welcome.
Thank you for having us here at Duke Robotics.
Of course, my pleasure.
Boyuan, thank you so much for having us in your lab here at Duke University today.
My pleasure.
So you work in robotics. Can you describe for our audience what is a robot?
So robots are any physical machines that we can control and program to work in the real world.
And what would be some examples that our audience may be familiar with or recognize as robots working in our society?
Yeah, we've seen lots of robots already in the real world. So this could be robots that can be cleaning your floor as Roomba, or robots that you see as autonomous vehicles on the road.
You're working at the leading edge of the field of robotics. What do you do? What is your group doing today to advance robotics?
So we call ourselves as a full stack robotics lab, where we build both the brain and the body of robots, where we call ourselves as working in the intersection of robotics and artificial intelligence. So things we build can look into the natural form of intelligence, including how babies perceive the world. So we are building robots that can perceive the world from many different sensing modalities like vision, sound, or vibrations, but also robots that can adapt on their own and work with other humans or robots as a whole team, and even help with accelerating scientific discovery.
We often hear about artificial intelligence, AI, and machine learning, and we know it's transforming almost every field and industry. Can you describe the role of AI machine learning in the area of robotics?
I think one of the major advancements in AI machine learning is to be able to understand a vast amount of data at the same time. So nowadays we have lots of data, no matter from they are from robots or from any sensory systems that we have. We're recording tons of data, but we do not have a very systematic way to understand them. What's critical in robotic system is for us to go from the sensoring capability of robots, for example, their cameras or microphones, to go to make the final decisions as robots. And what's very challenging for robotics is to make sure we make the right decisions with the data. How can we go from the perception data to the decision-making that control the robots? And even more, how do we make sure these control commands are safe for humans?
Given some of that pioneering work you're doing, are there one or two key application areas that you're using to motivate your work and where you're trying to validate your work?
Absolutely. So we're looking at two key areas. One thing is, well, we're very strong here at Duke, the medical sciences. We're looking into how we can partner with healthcare providers to have robots to be assistive nurses, or robots can be assistive surgeons to perform physical healthcare providing system. And the other application we're looking at is on field robotics, how robots can help us to perceive and explore the environment, and robots can help with search and rescue tasks, and even, you know, getting resources that we are not able to get into.
Wow, and I bet you there's even opportunity for that with respect to climate change and understanding our environment.
Absolutely.
What do you see are some of the biggest risks for robotics in our society as this technology rapidly emerges?
I think one is we're lacking kind of a science of understanding how robots will team up together with humans. When we see lots of robots, and in my view, we're gonna see robots outnumber humans in the future, how do we make sure that robots and humans can coexist and robots will safely interact with humans in a trustworthy manner?
Given the work you do, do you believe there's any special aspect of Duke that really makes us unique in the robotics field?
Yeah, I think one thing we see here, first of all, is a very strong energy, both from students and faculties who have a very strong desire to grow robotics. If you see in the past 2 years, we have grown lots of efforts in robotics, both from, you know, students who are taking courses and faculty doing research and hiring more people to join us on this journey. The other thing I see is unique facilities we have here at Duke. They're very strong on medical sciences, and one of the strong push is to automate part of healthcare systems. And here we can have the unique facility to perform lots of experiments we cannot do even elsewhere.
One of the most important things we do as faculty at Duke University is teach the next generation of engineers. What are some of the classes that students can take in the robotics space, and are they part of a larger program?
We have lots of robotics classes in the past recent 2 years, including Introduction to Robotics, Robot Learning. And this is actually a very large effort we're building now. We recently launched a certificate program for both undergraduate students and graduate students in robotics. And we're about to launch a master program in robotics in next year.
Can you describe ways that we're training our engineers here at Duke to be leaders in the technology of robotics?
Of course. So one approach I take is to really challenge the students' creativity and engineering capabilities. One course we're teaching here, we call it Robot Studio, is to challenge students to build a legged robotic system from scratch, going from sketching their ideas all the way to build a physical robot and using AI to control these robots. Eventually, we have a competition in front of Duke Chapel for both dancing and walking. So I found this is actually a very good way for us to inspire students to build the robots that they like, and actually they can take the robots with them as their future job hunting.
I wish I was a student again. Really cool. Boyuan, thank you for generously sharing with us today all the amazing work you're doing here at Duke Robotics. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. So robots have long been part of Hollywood. Do you have a favorite robot from the movies?
Actually, the most recent one is the Wild Robot. This is the one we actually bring the whole lab to watch in the movie theater. My favorite scene is actually when the robots observe the environment first and eventually learn how to communicate with other entities in surrounding it. It shows us how robots will look like when they coexist with animals and humans instead of replacing humans or animals. So this is one of the best illustrations we have seen so far.
So Wild Robot, yep. I will definitely check that out.